Hi all, I'm Raghav Mehta and today I'm going to talk about our work on unsigned evaluation metric for brain tumor segmentation. We are organizing a sub-challenge on quantification of uncertainty in brain tumor segmentation tasks with Broad's challenge at MICAI 2020. Please follow us on Twitter for more information. This work is in collaboration with my supervisor, Professor Tal Arbel at McGill University and Angelos Pilos and Yaren Gal from University of Oxford. Automatic brain tumor segmentation is of clinical importance as it can be used for various tasks like diagnosis and staging of tumor, outcome prediction, surgical planning, etc. As is the case with various medical imaging tasks, deep learning models have been outperforming other methods on brain tumor segmentation tasks in the popular MICAI-Broad's challenge. But tumor segmentation is a really hard problem due to a variety of reasons like variability in size, shape, or position of tumor, boundaries between different substructures of tumor, etc. Take an example given here. The boundary between necrotic core and enhancing tumor is really difficult to identify. Due to these reasons, deep learning models or machine learning models make mistakes. We can see here that for whole tumor segmentation, there are false positive and false negative voxels. Thus, this type of errors in machine learning algorithms lead to mistrust by clinicians, and in turn, it increases the hesitance of clinicians in including these models into a clinical workflow. So, how do we solve this problem? Answer is to define confidence in results of the models by defining uncertainties. This will bring clinicians back into the workflow. Bayesian deep learning models are useful for this as it provides not only the output but also uncertainties associated with it. This type of uncertainty will enable clinicians to focus on reviewing only the most uncertain prediction and trust the most confident predictions. This can help in reducing the overall burden on the reviewing clinicians. To quantify this goal, metric used to evaluate uncertainty must have following two properties, which measures that confident predictions should be correct and incorrect prediction should have higher uncertainties. As mentioned before, this will allow clinicians to only review most uncertain predictions without increasing overall burden. For this, we compute the uncertainty of a model at each voxel. Then we filter out the most uncertain prediction. We expect that this will result in increasing the performance in terms of the metric of interest here, DICE, on the remaining voxels. This measures that the incorrect predictions are the most uncertain one. Take an example given here. As we filter out more and more uncertain voxels by decreasing the uncertainty threshold, from figure, we can see that this results in increasing DICE on the remaining voxels for both example slices. But we don't want to increase the performance by filtering out the correct predictions, as this will increase the burden on the reviewing clinicians. For this reason, we penalize the models which filter out correct predictions more compared to other models. Take an example given here. We can see that for both example 1 and example 2, DICE increases as we filter out more voxels. But we can also see that while example 1 is filtering out incorrect predictions in terms of false positive or false negative, example 2 is filtering out more true positives compared to false negatives. For this reason, we penalize models which produces uncertainty similar to example 2. Now, we benchmark some popular uncertainty generation methods using 3D unit architecture on Broad's 2019 training dataset. Here, we analyze whole tumor segmentation and use entropy as an uncertainty measure. In the first curve on the left-hand side, we can see that as we decrease uncertainty threshold, we get higher DICE for all methods. But this is also at the expense of filtering out more true positive or true negative. We can see that on the remaining two graphs. We measure this by plotting DICE or filter true positive or true negative versus uncertainty thresholds and computing AUC for them. We use this metric for ranking different methods in Broad's 2019 challenge, and we are also organizing it this year. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions, please come by our virtual poster session from 1:30 p.m. to 3 p.m. on Wednesday, 8th July.